I don't believe in bringing a problem without a solution. Each of us who has touched education knows what the problem is. I suggest we get together and look at the disparity of resources that are available for these babies and put them all in one pot. President Obama saw it a few years ago when he put the monies at Central Piedmont Community College for voc ed. He saw what you're talking about. He sees it now by proposing the two-year free. CPCC already has a high school program where our students can graduate with an AA and a high school diploma. My suggestion for a possible beginning cure for all of these things is to put all of these programs in one pot and see what fits for citizen schools. It used to be citizen school in the 60s, so communities and schools.
I totally agree with you, and I agree with the gentleman over here who mentioned about self-discipline. Like, I think there are tons of resources in West Charlotte, particularly, like you mentioned, CPCC. Every black student, male, that graduates from West Charlotte High School receives the Anthony Fox Scholarship, $1,000, receives that. And so, like, there are tons of resources there, but it all points to self-discipline. And it, what you mentioned, with kids, you know, the principal can say, take your headphones off. But if you don't have that self-discipline in yourself to sit in class and learn, like me, I was an ADD kid, proud of it, you know. I was that hyper kid, Ms. Thompson, I don't remember being Butler. But I was that hyper kid. And at the same time, I didn't get the self-discipline, but people had to speak life into me. Still, they had to pull that out of me and show me who I really was, you know? That's what it came about. And so I don't think there's a shortage of resources. I really don't. I think we do a good job pointing people, like even the basic needs thing, crisis ministry, you know, like we just appointed free and reduced lunch. That's air for West Charlotte High School. And it's not a shortage of resources. I should say that.